morning, students. So today we are going to learn about the fundamental unit of life, cell. This topic is in the class 9 science, and this is the first chapter of biology portion in the class 9. So we are going to understand cell, the discovery. This which you are looking at is a scientist which is called Robert Hooke. He discovered the first cell. He discovered the first cell from visualizing under the primitive microscope. This is an image of primitive microscope which he only designed. And he saw the cork cells. Cork is a dead tissue of the plant obtained from the bark of the tree. So it is seen as a honeycomb like structure. And these each compartments which you see as hexagonal compartments, he said that these are cells. Now, cell is the fundamental unit of life. All living organisms are made of cells. It is the structural and functional unit of life because whole body is made of cell. Whether we say, take an example of lactobacillus, that is the bacteria responsible for turning milk into curd, or if we take example of human nerve cell which help us to know outer world, which help us to think, which make us intelligent. So these all are cells, therefore they are unit of life. Now the cells is a latent word for a little room. Robert Hooke in 1665 discovered the cell. Unicellular and multicellular organism. Based on number of cells an organism has, the organisms are divided into two types. Unicellular, if they consist of only single cell. Multicellular, if they consist of many cells. Unicellular organism composed of single cell. Single cell constitute the structure and entire function of the organism. Means respiration is only done by that cell. Nutrition is only done by that cell. Movement is also done by that cell. Means all the functions of organism are performed by single cell. Example is amoeba, paramecium, eudena. You can see these are all protozoa. And single cell is only having food vacuole, it is having nucleus, it is having plasmodium, pseudopodium. So now here you see paramecium, it is slipper shaped organism having cilia which help it to moving. And this is eudena having a flagella for movement. So this is unicellular organism. Now coming to multicellular organism, these are the organisms which are made up of more than single type of cell. So their body consists of many cells. Division of labor can also be seen in these organisms. What do you mean by division of labor? It means that particular group of cells are contributed for particular function. For example, in our body, some cells which are having the ability to contract and relax, they are called as muscle cells. They make our muscles. For example, facial muscles. My facial muscles right now are helping me to convey the information to you. I am using my vocal cords to convey the message to you. So these are all muscles. Now, this is known as division of labor. When particular type of cells are doing particular function. Now, plants, animals and human beings are multicellular organisms. You can see in our body there are bone cells which are star shaped, ovum which is an egg cell which is found in female, sperm cell which is having head and tail, red blood cells which are having transporting ability for oxygen, nerve cell which are helping us in thinking. So this is known as division of labor, when different kind of cells help in different functions. Now coming to the next, cell structure. As in the first slide we all know and define the cell as structural and functional unit of life. So what is the structure of cell? Structure of cell, you can see here, at the outermost boundary there will be a separation or compartmentalization that is done by cell membranes. Cells are covered by a boundary called as cell membranes. And in case of plant cell, because this is a diagram of plant cell, so plasma membrane, there is also a thick wall which is known as cell wall. So, cell wall is this green color thick structure which is giving a particular shape to the plant cell, and cell membrane is the yellow color structure which is very flexible, which is inner to the cell wall. This is cell membrane. Now coming to filamentous cytoskeletons. These are fiber-like structures. These are giving support to the cell structure. Now coming to the thylakoid membrane or membranous structure called green in color called as chloroplast. Vacuoles, a bigger blue color structure is shown here, which is means taking large amount of space called as vacuole. Mitochondria, it is also having a green light green color here, and this is powerhouse of the cell. Peroxisomes are tiny bag like structures which are also present, which helping in oxidation. Cytoplasm, this jelly like structure like blue in color is cytoplasm. Golgi vesicles, Golgi body, and rough endoplasmic reticulum covering a yellow structure in the center called as nucleus. So this kind of we can say structure make your cell. Cells are made of components called as cell organelles. Nucleus is a cell organelles, endoplasmic reticulum, ribosomes, vacuoles, chloroplast, these are all the names of organelles. Cell is capable to live and perform their respective functions because of presence of cell organelle only. The structure seen in almost every cell, there are three structures which will be common to all cells. What are those structures? Plasma membrane, nucleus, and cytoplasm. Now we will move to next slide. This is cell wall. Found in the plants, this is a special feature, and this gives rigid structure to the plant. Rigid covering made of cellulose provides structural support to the plant cells. Now, plasma membrane and its function. It is the outermost covering of every cell, and it separates the cell components from outer world. It helps in selective transport of exchange of materials in and out of the cell, and it helps in diffusion and osmosis. Composed of bilayer of lipid and protein. This is the structure. This yellow color ball like structures and these stick like structures are lipid membrane. This blue color structures are proteins, and these green colors coming out of them are glycolipids or carbohydrates. So all three biomolecules are present in your plasma membrane. Now cytoplasm, the jelly like substance which is here is in light brown color shown. This gel is we can say making a medium of the cell in which all the things will be transported. This thick solution composed of water, salts, proteins, filling the cell is known as cytoplasm. And surrounded by cell membrane. Nucleus of the cell is surrounded by cytoplasm. Now coming to the next nucleus. This is the central organelle. This is also known as brain of cell, because it is having the DNA of the cell, which helps in the transfer of genetic material from one cell to another cell. Small round membrane mount structures near the center of the cell. Fluid filled in the nucleus is called nucleoplasm. Covered by double layer, you can see this is a double layer of the nucleus having pores called nucleopores, and inside them there is a thread-like structure called as chromatin and a dark color region called a nucleolus. And the function of segment of DNA are called genes. So our genes are transferred from one organism to another through the nucleus. Now Golgi apparatus. This bag-like stack of bag-like structures, membranous bag-like structures known as Golgi. And these single bag is known as cisternae. There are some forming vesicles, tiny globules, which are also bud off from the Golgi. And this is first described by Camillo Golgi, therefore it gives have its name from. It is a system of membrane mount vesicles called cisternae, and function includes storage, modification, and packaging of cell products. Whatever proteins are made in another organelle known as endoplasmic reticulum are modified here. If some of the groups are to be added, they are added in the Golgi. So this is the function, modification. Complex sugars are made from simple sugars in the Golgi apparatus. It's also informing the formation of lysosomes, that is digestive bodies. Now lysosomes, these are sac-like digestive bodies. This is shown like green in color, and separately, these are having a large number of digestive enzymes, which can our ability to break down the substances which enter inside the lysosomes. So sac like structures surrounded by membrane containing powerful digestive enzymes. Enzymes are made up of RER and digest the water out cells. When the cell get damaged, lysosomes burst and the enzymes digest their own cell. This is also therefore known as suicide bag, self-killing bag. So it is a waste disposal system, cleanup process, lysosome. Mitochondria is the, you can see a brown color mitochondria in a yellow, highly membranous folded membrane. This is mitochondria, it's covered by double membrane, and outer membrane is very porous and inner membrane is deeply folded, and it is involved in making energy currency of the cell known as adenosine triphosphate, ATP molecule. ATP is the energy currency, and therefore mitochondria, which makes that ATP, is known as powerhouse. And mitochondria have their own DNA and ribosome, therefore they can make their own proteins. Plastids are the double membrane covered structures. Again, they are also having green color in them, and they are called chloroplasts. They have their own DNA ribosomes and they are found only in plant cells. Enfolding of membrane called thylakoids inside internal membrane also folded upon, and this stack of the, this single one is known as thylakoid and the stack is known as granum. And there is a viscous liquid also present in the chloroplast called as stroma. And two types, chromoplast, colored plastic chloroplast, contain green pigment chlorophyll and useful in the photosynthesis, and contain other pigments like yellow and orange also. Leucoplasts are also the plastids which are different from chloroplasts. Chloroplast will have chlorophyll, green in color, but leucoplasts will be white or colorless. They will be the same membrane bound bodies, but they will help in storage of food materials, carbohydrates, proteins, fats. This is the end of the slide. So in the next presentation, we are going to understand about the animal cells and the functions of plasma membrane, that is osmosis. Thank you.